likes for this videos. If we get more than 2,000 likes at this videos, we will upload more patriotic news. Seconds ago, Trump reveals on what Obama was spending Americans' money, insight immediately. Millions of U.S. taxpayer dollars were being foolishly wasted paying for the salaries of non-existent ghost soldiers and policemen in Afghanistan under the Obama administration, but no more. Based on the words of the Special Inspector General for Afghanistan Reconstruction, John Sopko, who not long ago had an interview with Cheryl Atkinson of Full Measure, the ongoing problem may have grown to be worse than anyone noticed, but was being dealt with by President Trump's Pentagon. "We've been raising this concern about ghosts going back a number of years," said Sopko. "Actually, I want to say we heard about it from Afghan President Ashraf Ghani years ago. Before he became president, he warned me about ghosts, so we started looking 3 years ago. What we're talking about are policemen, Afghan military, Afghan civil servants who don't exist or they have multiple identity cards and we're paying their salaries," he revealed. "By we I mean the United States and the international community. And we started finding out that we had no capacity to measure the number of soldiers, teachers, doctors, military people who we are paying their salaries." When asked if this suggested fraud had been going on, Sopko answered, "Major fraud. And what's happening is the commanders or generals or other higher officials are actually pocketing the salaries of the ghosts. And I remember President Ghani again, at that time he wasn't president, saying, 'John, you the United States government are paying the salary of an Afghan who's a teacher, he's a civil servant, he's a doctor, he is a policeman, and he's a soldier. And it's the same Afghan. And he doesn't exist,'" Sopko described. "It's not just the salaries," he said in addition. "But we're funding schools based upon the number of students, so if you invent or inflate the number of students, you're going to be paying more money. On the soldiers and the police, we're paying for extra boots, for food, for everything else, logistics for numbers that don't exist." Sopko had notified Pentagon on countless occasions to what he had found out in 2016, but very little was done to deal with the matter by the administration of President Barack Obama, although Fox News informed that the Pentagon had reported at the time that they would quickly apply certain measures to try and overcome the rampant fraud bilking U.S. taxpayers of hundreds of millions of dollars. The Independent Journal Review reveals that Atkinson noted that the Pentagon had integrated a biometric system that inspected this sort of things like fingerprints, photographs and even blood type in an effort to acquire proof of life of Afghan service members to be able to weed out the non-existent ghosts that have cost taxpayers a whole lot. While it is extremely doubtful that any of the taxpayer dollars lost by this fraud will ever be reclaimed, at least measures have been taken to make sure more dollars aren't wasted in the apparently never-ending bid to reconstruct Afghanistan. If you want to spread the word about the non-existent ghost soldiers in Afghanistan that have been bleeding American taxpayers dry for years, share this story. Reveal Trump made brave move to shut Obama's shadow golf for good. Breaking: Trump made brave move to shut Obama's shadow golf for good. April 27, 2017, The Political Tribune 34. Trump is going to shut down Obama's shadow government. IT's official. The deep state's towers are falling down. The global elite suffers in agony. Barack Obama managed to be one of the strongest and smartest liberal elitists. I will give him this title because, unlike Hillary and McCain, he succeeded the best of them all liberal minions, and has a huge commitment for the globalists' agenda and their shadow government. Shadow government, deep state words that remind us of something cruel and dark. It is not a conspiracy. Just look what they did to the USA. These liberals tried to create an ignorant and dependent nation. Just look what they do, stupid little welfare policy instead of giving jobs, mainstream media brainwashing instead of free will and proper education, LGBT and terrorism instead of religion, spirituality and tranquility. That's what they want to do. Donald Trump stopped them. He suddenly came out of nowhere and cracked their system. From that moment on, the frustrated and desperate liberal elitists try to stick to their shadow government. Obama's leftover spied on Trump, that's for sure. Comey and the NSA tried to sell fake stories. They said that the Trump Tower had been under surveillance due to the presence of some Russian mob boss. Nice excuse. In the end of Flynn's investigation, it was also confirmed that he is clear and innocent, but spied on him anyway. Just to sell fake news stories to discredit the president. And again, nothing happens. The liberals always get away with their crimes. Not anymore. Donald Trump started the final destruction of the liberal deep state. Trump just embedded 16 hand-chosen aides into multiple federal agencies to both monitor and report back on the actions of existing cabinet secretaries. According to Washington Post and confirmed by Angry Patriot Movement, "We are happy to announce the end of the filthy snake's realm. Drain the swamp." After the threat to stop with that, Trump just did the opposite. He proves to be a big fighter and a bold patriot. Behind the scenes, though, they're on another mission, to monitor cabinet leaders and their top staffs to make sure they carry out the president's agenda and don't stray too far from the White House's talking points. Told by multiple WH officials with knowledge of the new arrangement to the Washington Post. God bless the president. Finally. This is what we've been all waiting for so long. We cannot make America great again if there is a huge snake around our neck. Trump will stomp the snake's head. Do you support Trump? Everybody share the good news. Share this post on your Facebook and Twitter profile. Game changer. It is unbelievable what our leader Trump is ready to do over the night. The U.S. president met with the leaders of Canada and Mexico, and they ended up with a decision to renegotiate the North American Free Trade Agreement, NAFTA, according to the White House. On Thursday, the U.S. president stated that he is looking forward to terminating the trade agreement if there is no fair deal. "It is my privilege to bring NAFTA up to date through renegotiation," was Trump's statement. "It is an honor to deal with both Mexican President Peña Nieto and Canadian Prime Minister Trudeau, and I believe that the end result will make all three countries stronger and better. I received calls from the President of Mexico and the Prime Minister of Canada asking to renegotiate NAFTA rather than terminate. I agreed." Donald J. Trump, at Real Donald Trump, April 27, 2017. The White House just made a statement which says that Trump won't agree not to terminate NAFTA at this time, and instead, U.S., China, and Mexico will proceed swiftly according to their required internal procedures, to enable the renegotiation of NAFTA. Subject to the fact that if we do not reach a fair deal for all, we will then terminate NAFTA. Relationships are good deal very possible. Donald J. Trump, at Real Donald Trump, April 27, 2017, "Our President Trump is definitely sticking to his promises. There are no doubts he is fixing the trade agreements, as he made two countries to seek solutions and cooperate with him. Here is everything Donald Trump is preparing to do. Our president is playing his cards right, even though the mass media is trying to discredit him by selling us some cheap lies. Fortunately, he doesn't really care about that, but rather cares about us, the people of America, being as effective and productive as possible. We would be happy to hear your thoughts and predictions." Amazing Baron Trump to be the first son in half a century. Ever since the beginning, the youngest of the U.S. president's sons, Baron Trump, represents the main target for the leftist attacks and accusations, but in the meantime is guarded by the conservatives, which happens to get him a lot of media attention. He responds to all of these activities by trying not to engage in anything for as long as he can. The First Lady is fully dedicated to taking care of him and removing all of the bad influence, as she is staying with him at Trump Towers all along the academic year. We all get the impression of how hard it is to be the first kid, by all of the unnecessary media attention Baron has gotten. It's not the first time we see cute and amazing children being first kids in the White House, but not so many cases as Baron's, cases of being the first boy. The first boy will be officially staying at the White House, a thing which hasn't happened ever since the inauguration of John F. Kennedy. We hope to be seeing Baron in the House for the following 8 years. As Time magazine states, in the 19th century, the occupants of the White House had herds of boys. The Lincolns had four. The Grants had three sons and a daughter. The Hayeses had seven sons and a daughter, reported Time. The Garfields had seven kids, five of them sons. Not all of these male heirs lived in the White House. Many died young, or were too old to be living with their parents, but several did. Despite the Trump's attempts to get Barron away from the media's eyes, he was the first one to leave the door when the airplane transporting the family for the inauguration landed in Washington. We are all anxious to see how Will Barron get through these events while being the first boy in 50 years. Revealed Ivanka Trump gets booed in Germany. Then, she gives them this response. The daughter of the president, Ivanka Trump, had an appearance today. She gave a speech at a women's summit in Germany. But, the left-leaning audience didn't like her quoting President Trump, as they started heckling at her. But they for sure didn't like her response as well, as she showed self-discipline and tolerance way above theirs, showing she, as well as her father, can easily deal with the leftists. Their reaction came as a result of Ivanka's statement that the U.S. president has always proudly stood for and supported women, helping them succeed all along his career as a businessman. Once the disregarding audience started making unpleasant noise, Ivanka had no choice but to find a way of calming them down, and she did nothing less. Only one reply was enough to shut everyone up. I know from personal experience, and I think the thousands of women who have worked with and for my father for decades are a testament to his belief and solid conviction in the potential for women. I grew up in a house where there were no barriers to what I could accomplish, beyond my own perseverance and tenacity. There was no difference for me and my brothers. Her empirical argument most likely made everyone who has booed feel ashamed, since she explained what is it like to be Donald Trump's daughter and grow up in a family without any gender borders. She also, once again, reminded us of how good person and tremendous champion of supporting feminists her father is, despite making an awesome president. You can also check up the video shortcut of the summit, and see yourselves what am I talking about. We would be happy to hear your thoughts and predictions.